My name is Laura Caulfield, and I work at Winkler Films with Irwin Winkler, producer-director of Rocky's Raging Bull, The Right Stuff, Goodfellas, and I've had an outstanding career here. What we at Winkler Films look at for in projects are character-driven pieces where the audience can identify with the character. The character needs to have depth. A lot of different things need to be going on at different levels in this character's life. I find that the scripts that are the most interesting are those that are written from experience, where a writer can talk about something that they know about, that they have first-hand experience with. It's often very common that people will write about something that they don't have any experience with. And you can see that in the writing, that they're fabricating it, or that they're sort of cookie-cutting what they think Hollywood wants to see. And it's really much more interesting when somebody is writing from experience. Some of the most common mistakes that we see in screenplays that are brought into the company are dialogue. People tend to give everything away in dialogue. The character will literally tell you, rather than having it come to you through dialogue. It would be nice to see it unfold through action. Sometimes it's very difficult to get a point across simply through action, and dialogue can indicate that. But it tends to be overwritten. People are afraid that people don't understand what they're trying to say, so they will write on and on and make their point 1, 2, 3, 4 times in the same sequence. And really, the audience hopefully is intelligent enough that you can hint to a point, and the audience will pick up on it. The character will speak to you through other forms of language besides just dialogue. And also in descriptions of the scene, the setup of the environment in which the person is having their dialogue or their action tends to be also overwritten. People will write paragraphs which are just unnecessary and actually makes it for a slow read. It needs to move quickly. The pacing needs to keep moving so that you can engage people in it, so that they're interested in watching, so they're compelled and they want to know what happens next to this character.
We have covered a great deal of ground already, but there are a few other resources we would like you to be aware of. Firstly, there are two main trade papers in the industry, The Hollywood Reporter and The Daily Variety. Both papers publish 5 days a week and are available by subscription. If you're going to keep up with what's happening in film and TV, you need to be looking at the trades on a regular basis. And now, here to talk to you about the benefits of the film commissions in your area and the need to own your own screenplays are Annie Chen and Shireen Nomura.
Hi, my name is Annie Chen. As a writer for television or film, one of the most valuable resources you'll find is the film commission in your area. Every year, the film commissions from all 50 states and from all over the world gather together for 3 days at the Location Expo here in Southern California to get a better idea what the film commissions do and how they can help you. We talked to a few of the commissioners.
I work for the LA County Film Office, and we get a barrage of requests from different students from the universities, USC, American Film Institute, etc. And a lot of times they come and they're really lost as far as what packaging they need to, for example, start a film project, because first of all, they're going to need a permit to film. And we'll give them policies and procedures, different locations, where to film, and we're all housed on one floor, the State Film Commission, as well as the County Film Office and the City Film Office. For example, they can go right next door to the State Film Commission Office and look through a location library, which is a wealth of information of different specific areas that they may want to shoot, be it a beach, a park, whatever scene they want. And they can go right next door to the city if it's in their jurisdiction where the permit would have to be obtained, or come to us. And we also help them with a package of insurance from the school, which is a prerequisite, and also just policies and procedures of what they'll need for filming, because we'll waive their permit fees, for example, because we know they're struggling going to school to get a certain project done.
And also,
so all they simply have to do is put on the school letterhead what project they're doing and the specifics of what they're doing.
Sure.
And they're waived those fees, and they're entitled to film at whatever location deemed necessary for them. So we try to be of great assistance for them in that endeavor. And then a lot of times they'll ask additional questions of where they can get a certain prop, or do you know where I can get certain costumes, and we'll lend a hand. And a lot of times we're familiar with different areas and aspects of that, and we'll assist them with that. So it's like a full package of information, and they're so grateful.
Well, we provide them with cooperation at a number of different levels. If they need research, we're able to help them with research throughout the Chicagoland area, whether that involves just basic stories, maybe involving police, maybe involving the city itself, the history of the city, neighborhoods, the park system, the waterway areas, all of that we're able to help them with, as well as with the actual production part of the operation, which would provide them with assistance on the street, with street, closing streets, providing permits and information on logistics and crews.
Well, our film commission, like most film commissions, is set up to assist filmmakers who are coming to Texas to make films, although we work very closely with our own production people as well. Photographic library of thousands and thousands of photos of the state of Texas, assist them in locations, also trying to assist them in finding services and individuals who work in the film-related business so that they can crew up, whether it be gaffers or grips or production assistants or makeup or catering and that sort of thing. And the idea being is that to give them as much information about shooting in the state of Texas, make it easier for them. And the way we do that is through a Texas production manual, which lists companies and individuals that are television and film related. And it's kind of cross-referenced between the various cities, the major cities, and also assisting them with when they get there and shooting with state and agencies, highway closures, setting up, dealing with state agencies, also dealing with the private and public sector and helping them find locations. And just trying to make their production as easy as possible so if they have any problems, they can come to us. And that's basically what a film commission does.
Jamaica is a film commission. However, things are a little different for us because we are an island. We have customs and immigration that we have to deal with. So our film commission focuses on cutting all the bureaucracy that you would normally have in a situation like ours, where you have to go from state to state. You don't have the problems that we would have. So our film commission concentrates on policy, where we try and cut all the red tape for our clients, production companies, and we also try to get incentives, just like all the other commissions as well, to get some kind of attraction to producers that they would want to come to Jamaica and they would want to leave their money in Jamaica because we're not a member of the United States. That's basically what we do. We create policies that are attractive and we cut bureaucratic red tape. Now, film commissioners, as the head of the commission, are the liaising agents in Jamaica, just like anywhere else, that would present these policies to the government and coordinate an office which deals with all the cutting of the bureaucracy that you would normally have. Location scouting is also one of the functions that we perform, and we also get the crew in Jamaica to a standard of training and participating, as well as promoting the crew in Jamaica, because a lot of foreigners and foreign production companies do not know how good our crews are. So we try and let that be known, and we also try and upgrade their skills. So we sometimes have workshops for writers and workshops for various types of crew, anything from grip to directors. So we are not the normal film commission in that we do have to try and do this training program. Normal film commissioners in the States, in the United States, would have private sector companies as well as universities that teach these programs. But our university doesn't focus on feature film, it focuses on television. So we therefore have to do the training from our office. And we do this, as I said, by liaising with companies over here who want to come to Jamaica for a nice week, and we use that week which to train our crew. As a commissioner, a past commissioner, some of the more challenging things are to work with the government agencies in Jamaica to make them aware of film so that they will help us to cut bureaucratic red tape. We have no problem with customs and immigration. We've worked with them for many years and they now understand filming. We are allowed to clear people without any problems whatsoever. We have requirements for work permits, which are waived because of contacts with our office over the years. They now understand that this is not necessary. So the main goal of any commissioner in Jamaica is to make filming in Jamaica as easy as filming it in one state to another. And that's what we do.